Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to discuss that why parents should read books to the toddlers and preschoolers, what's their importance. I have kind of read a lot when I'm having and raising my child and trying to follow some practices, some best practices while raising the children. And over a period of time, that whatever I mention here is something which I have personally seen and observed with my daughter, and that's where it's my thought based on her things. It might be a little different for you, but yes, I feel that in more than 90% of the cases you will find a good reason to start this and good results also. So let us go through in the details. So first thing is that child's vocab, the knowledge of their words. Have you ever wondered the children's knowledge of the words? Their vocab is exactly like their mom or anyone who is a caretaker till they actually start going to the schools. And why do you think so that it is?
Because
they are just observing their daily life with them, from all the chores to all the interactions which they see. It can be interactions between one member of the family to two members to three members, but they will be knowing, observing and knowing all those words only. That is what they will be building over a period of time, and nothing more than that. Yes, friends, that's true, because they don't know, they have not observed it and no one have told it, then how can we expect them to know it? Yeah, it's not a rocket science as a parent, even if we are teacher by profession or not, we are parents, and we can, read some basic story books. Eventually, we'll be having our learning phase where it might not interest them a lot, but over a period of time, if we have that interest and that attitude that we can read storybooks the way they enjoy, we'll be even reading the storybooks in a very fun way where they will be getting all the fun through the books. The only aspect is that we have to be aware of that this thing add value to your children, because sometimes I really feel now that when I was reading the books at the year, like 1 year, I was just focusing on words. I was not trying to read her sentences, specifically in English, because there were some interactions which I used to do with my husband, and that too used to be in my language. But in English, I was just telling more on one word, and then something in my own language, Hindi, and just moving on. I had kind of assumed that she might not understand or she might not learn. But here is where I went wrong, and that is where she's knowing all the words, alphabets, but not able to form sentences, because I haven't, given that confidence in her that she could do. So at 1 year, like if she's able to absorb that, she would also have absorbed sentences also. So when I should have read the books, I should have read it like sentences rather than just doing words by words. So that's my recommendation, friends. Don't underestimate that if they are like 1 year of age or 2 year of age or 3 year of age, what they are going to understand. They are going to understand and they are learning. And their mind is like a sponge. That's what it's mentioned. It's like a sponge during these early years. So whatever we tell them, we try to teach them, they are able to gain it. And that's the reason people learn most of their languages during the early stages, not afterwards. If as 39 or so, if I think today that I want to learn some different language, we cannot be able to do it now, because our capacity is not there. But as children, they have so much power in their brains that they can definitely learn those. So we have not to underestimate their power and not to assume that they might not understand. We have to be aware that they understand and then work towards it. So I was reading books, that is for sure, but I was not reading her the complete sentences, and I have observed impact of that. I really want that you as mom don't do that and read as much as possible the storybooks as much as possible, because that really adds a lot of value. And I will just come to it that why it adds value. So, we'll just come to that why it adds value, and Now, once you have to read the books, you know, you have to read the books, the interest will also come by the content. So the content selection is also very important. So you have to be for example, some textbooks with a lot of text, even we will not have that much of interest. Now consider a book where there are a lot of visuals with some basic lines or so, then we also get that in interest. And moreover, even if outside some scene we will remember, something will be remembered because it has visually created a difference. So we have to use the choice of the books have to be something where there is a visual and there is a word related to it or sentence related to it. That is how they will be able to register. So even content is more important. And the other thing is their interest. Like if you think that they are having interest in some particular specific thing which they are more willing to know or to read about, then give your reading in those areas so that they are more focused and interested to read the books and cooperate with you in those readings. So the content is also very important. So here comes the content selection. Now, now for example, why I'm saying that it gives a lot of value is that imagine if you read 4 to 5 books every day, daily to your child, and then they learn like almost like 100 to 200 words daily with those books, then how much they would learn over a month, how much they would learn over a year in 365 days, and how much they're going to learn over a period of time if they continue this, for 4 to 5 years. So by the time they are actually preschoolers or they're in school in first grade or so, they will be having a good amount of knowledge in terms of their word vocab. They will be able to create good sentences. They will be able to express themselves a lot better. And eventually, a lot of power of communication comes. You express your creativity and imagination, everything, because you are having the right, words to express yourself. So that is the gift which you can give to your child, most of us don't have, because we are not aware that how we can improve the vocab. At some point of time when we have that gap already, we try to bridge, when we prepare for some exams, we try to bridge by reading the dictionary, different books only for vocab. But then if we do this activity like reading the storybooks to the child of different types of the content which they are interested for, and sometimes the content even if they are not interested for, because first time you have to try to know the things whether it interests or not, right? So for small toddlers, it is something that which will take with their interest, but as they grow, we can do something even if they are interested or they are not interested, different type of content, different type of stuff which is good, with good moral values and good content. If we cover, then they are automatically getting a good amount of vocab. And once they have this reading habit, even if you don't read the book, and once they start the reading their book on their own, then imagine that how many books they will be reading going on, and how much the word vocab in whatever language, in whatever language, like your own language or English or any other language, how much they will be learning over a period of time. They will be learning a lot. So that's what is really going to help them. So yes, friends, as I end this video, I would like to say that consider that, child is capable of doing a lot. Their mind is like a sponge, and they are able to absorb a lot many things when we give them. So be aware of that, be cognizant of the fact, and then don't ignore this important aspect and read as many books as you can to them as children, and they are going to thank you in their later phases of their life, which create because if we don't read that, the early years, that creates a huge gap of words, and when they actually go to school, that in fact widens over a period of time. So till they start reading books on their own, read as much as possible, to them, and unleash the power of reading books to your children. So they will also get interest to do that, And they might get also addicted to even, you know, read the books on their own, which is a good hobby. So that's a trend. That's what I have, you know, something to discuss today. Hope you liked the video. And if you have liked it, then please give me a thumbs up. Also, please don't forget to mention something in comments, like what exactly you liked about it. And if there is any other question, don't hesitate, don't be hesitant to ask for that. Also do subscribe to my channel, because I will be loading some videos and you don't want to miss that. So yeah, that's it, friends. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Stay blessed and take care.